when you lose one cop, every cop in this country loses a brother.
I was there, Harvey. He was as close to me as you are now.
We wanted to be involved in the active part of this investigation.
One of my detectives lost his life. Can't have another one taking his or somebody else's.
I'm in no mood to play detective and witness. Come on, Mary Beth. You're pushing me.
Aren't you scared?
What I do can be very dangerous.
Would you pull yourself together?
Somebody we both worked with has been murdered.
Look at how you're acting.
I'm not the one that's acting strange, Christine.
Was anyone guarding the suspect?
Detective Newman, the team leader in this investigation, was there.
So the suspect was under guard.
I said Detective Newman was there, Counselor. That doesn't mean the suspect was under guard because somebody was there, does it?
The grand jury will decide what all this means, Detective Lacey.
What all this means is that I'm feeling rattled and my stomach is making noises you can hear in Jersey, and I cannot for the life of me do anything with this hair.
The members of the jury will take all of that into consideration.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Ready for my big day in court?
Just put it all in perspective.
It's a beautiful suit, Jonah.
It is, isn't it?
Newman, when somebody pays you a compliment, you're merely supposed to say thank you.
Like the skirt, Cagney. Oh, you have great legs.
Thank you. And nobody likes a wise guy, Newman.
You'd be surprised.
Cagney, when are you going to give me that report you promised me?
Today.
Today, you're going to be in court a whole day.
Lieutenant, you're the one who assigned me to narcotics.
I didn't like taking six detectives off the charge, but narcotics made a request. Now I'm making a request of you.
On your desk tonight.
Come hell or high water.
Yes, Lieutenant.
So there in the produce section is this chick, Trixie. Blonde, blue-eyed, with the kind of body that you find in billboards. So I mosey on up to her real slow and I say, how'd you like to have kids that look like me, huh?
Yo, hold on.
All right, maybe I didn't say that, but I do have a date with it tonight. And I am taking my toothbrush.
Hey, nice suit, Newman.
Thank you.
Quick study, Newman.
I bought it for the Detective of the Month luncheon.
A dark day in the history of the Union.
I am going to miss working undercover.
Hey, you get to hang out with characters more unsavory than you are.
Coleman, if we win, we'll be celebrating at Flannery.
And probably pick up the tab.
A solid conviction.
You know what this means. It's
getting around the place off.
Yes. Second grade detective is a shoo-in. Aren't you glad you nominated me for Detective of the Month?
Aren't you glad the award's not for humility?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Let's go celebrate. Dinner and drinks are on me.
Newman, look, I got this girl waiting for me, and if I'm late, she's the type that'll just start without me. So why don't we make it another time, huh?
Come on, it's back.
Hey, listen, you got plenty of other wins, man. Well, you buy me some drinks then.
That'll be my inspiration.
Take
life.
Have
are the rest
time.
Of you ready to party?
Ready.
Oh, sorry.
Don't, I can't make it.
I gotta go home. It's a PTA meeting at Michael's school. And can we do it another time? How about tomorrow, maybe?
You're off. Fine. How about you, Cagney?
I got paperwork to do. Newman?
I'd rather you tell me almost anything than hand me a line like that.
Really? Sammy's got on my case this morning. If I can't, I'll come by later, all right?
Yeah, I won't hold my breath.
Come on, Newman. We'll just have to party without him.
We don't know how to celebrate anyway.
Hey, don't get too crazy because we have to party all over again tomorrow.
Have a good time.
All right, do it again tomorrow.
Bye. Do you really have a PTA meeting tonight?
You think I'd lie about a thing like that?
I know I would.
Hey, Cagney!
You got some money I could borrow?
Are you kidding? You invite people out for dinner and drinks and you don't have any money? What kind of host are you?
The kind that left my wallet in my locker.
Didn't you have borrowed it from them?
They say I never pay back a loan.
It's good to know, Newman.
Everybody put on their shields.
Nothing's going to happen.
We're going to get your help. Please.
No, I want to stay with
him. That's an order.
No. Nothing's going to happen.
Oh, Jesus, bleeding. Anybody who saw what just happened, would you please step over here?
Jonah?
Give me your name.
You're going to be okay. You're very young. You're very strong. Get an ambulance. You're going to be fine. You're going to be fine.
Partner I had before Victor, Frank Mambelli. Back on patrol 2 weeks after he was shot. Fearless Frank, we call him.
He'll be fine.
It's a healthy kid.
The only second baseman we got.
Shortstop.
Shortstop if he's good enough. Second base if McIvey's got the edge. I'd bet on Newman. He's faster. It was. Well, McIvey lost weight.
Why didn't I see it coming?
Nobody here is to blame. Al, we have to hope for the best, that's all.
Dr. Harris, fourth floor. Dr. Harris, fourth floor.
I couldn't get here any sooner. How is he?
Still in surgery.
With an excellent team of doctors.
Can I do something? Can I give blood?
No, there's nothing to do but wait, Victor. Why don't you sit down?
I should have been there.
You think you could have done something to stop it from happening?
Maybe.
We were there. We couldn't stop it.
Any word on who did it?
Witness saw a car. Gave us the color, model, and a partial license plate number.
He'll stick around. I owe money from the last poker game. $60.
65.
I know him. He'll live to collect and wipe me out next time we play. All right.
I know you can't identify what kind of car it is, ma'am, but does the rear of this look familiar to you? Or maybe the front of these cars?
Petrie, I want a hotline man 24 hours a day.
I'll set it up.
And all information strictly confidential. Where's Cagney? Where the hell's Cagney?
The name of the man from Intelligence Division, sir, Peter Roth. You want me to get him down here?
It's a good thinking, Lacey.
Are you all right, Lieutenant? You want me to get you an aspirin or a cup of coffee?
Oh, no, I'm fine. Fine. Look, as soon as Cagney comes in, you send her back to my office?
Yes, sir.
Aspermonte, I want you to reach out to the 104 and grab me Warren Former.
Oh, yeah, he's supposed to be the great wireman?
Yeah, right. Yeah, Carassa, reach out and grab me Froelich from Brooklyn Homicide. And we also need a good street person, too.
Newman was the best.
Phone problem?
A teenager.
I called Claudia from the hospital.
I tried to get Harvey then, too, but he already left from Saratoga. I hope he's not listening to the car radio.
Claudia was watching TV. They said, a NYPD detective. No name, no precinct. She cried when she heard my voice.
They protected that officer's family. They worry everybody else's.
My families will have plenty to worry about if it's open season on cops.
Oh, Marcus.
I checked Newman's 10 card, Lieutenant. He'd been assigned two weapons. These are the serial numbers. His shield and his ID card and service revolver were found on his person. And I found his other weapon in his locker.
All the serial numbers match?
Yes. I also cleaned out the rest of his locker. I figured that Carassa wouldn't be up to it.
No, that's good work, sir. You sit down?
Thanks, I don't feel like sitting.
Yeah, I know the feeling. Want a little shot? Just a look?
No, thanks. I have some work I have to do.
Most a couple of years older than my own son, David. Loved working undercover, huh?
He was a hot dog.
He was a good cop.
I didn't say he wasn't, Lieutenant.
We're gonna get the bastard that gunned him down. Mark my words.
You shouldn't drink while on duty, Bert.
Yeah, I know.
Pour me one, too. I'm told you haven't released the name of the dead detective yet.
Yeah, I'll make a full statement to the press after all the proper notifications have been made to the boy's family. Boy had a family, so the damn vultures can wait.
We have a good relationship with the press, Bert. Let's keep it that way.
Look, I'm gonna send Al Carassa and the chaplain and you over to notify the next of kin.
Don't you want to do that yourself?
No, I got too much to do here. You're the second whip.
And didn't you and this Newman fellow work on a case together around Christmas time? Some street musician nonsense? That's good thinking, Bert. She's a woman, so's his mother. Might make it a little easier. It's very hard for widows and mothers.
Carassa knows where his mother lives.
Lieutenant.
No, look, there's nothing to discuss. There's no time. Just go ahead and do it.
They had me here for Thanksgiving last year. His mom's a great cook.
Have you done this before? If you're worried about what to say, you won't have to say much.
Oh, what a nice surprise. Rabbi?
I gotta call Marty Cat right now, okay? Forgive me. How you doing, baby? Mary Beth, I win $50. Marty Kaplan is not home. Marty Kaplan and his father-in-law, they are up in Saratoga doing a cousin's basement. We are 185 miles from Queens. I see him in a coffee shop. How's that for a coincidence, huh? Anyway, we bet 50 bucks. Who can get home faster?
Could have got a ticket.
I didn't.
Could have gotten an accident.
I didn't. I won 50 bucks, babe.
I was calling you.
What do you say? Tomorrow we paint the town, huh?
I was worried that you'd be worried.
What are you doing manicuring your nails now?
Did you hear me?
Yeah, I heard you. I've been gone 3 days. Aren't there better things we could be doing? Hmm?
Jonah Newman was killed today, Harvey. I was scared to death that you'd hear a detective got shot at the courthouse. And you were busy making some stupid bet with Marty Kaplan. Could have got you killed. I was there, Harvey. He was as close to me as you are now. We all were. Two shots from God knows where. A car, I think. I saw a car. And then he was down, and I held him in my arms. I hardly knew him, Harvey. He was a kid, you know, 27, 28 years old. The whole time we knew each other, I don't think we said 10 words. But I saw him every day. You get used to somebody you see all the time.
Yeah.
And I told him, you'll be okay. At the hospital, we told each other, he'll be okay. But somehow you know. We knew.
Thank God, man.
No, don't say it, Harvey. Don't even think it. This case in court, he was so excited that we won. It was the most important thing in the world to him. I told him I had to go to the PTA meeting and we'd celebrate tomorrow. Tomorrow, I said.
We all regret this terrible tragedy. But the important thing is to remain calm, be cautious, and don't overreact. Might even be a good idea for the next couple of days to wear a bulletproof vest.
That's not overreacting.
The Detectives Endowment Association has asked me to announce a $10,000 reward for information that leads to the arrest and conviction of this killer. And the mayor has matched that reward. It's a tribute to your fallen comrade that you've elected to return to work when you've all been excused for the rest of the day. But I know we all feel that when you lose one cop, every cop in this country loses a brother or a sister.
Great time to get enlightened.
I thank you all. Bert, can we talk for a minute, please?
Ask for Monty.
Yeah?
You check for that narcotics case we just finished, please.
Will do.
I'll check his past and present cases for revenge motive.
I'm going through his Rolodex. Maybe it was a crime of passion.
Yeah, a lot of these drive-by shootings are gang initiation. Well, I bet somebody was out to off a cop.
Well, he was in all the papers since he was detective of the month.
Which made him a target. Is that what you're trying to say, Victor?
I think we have to treat it like any other homicide.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm packing extra weapons out there. I'm in a situation where I gotta draw my guns. I'm gonna shoot first and ask questions later.
Come on, Carrasco. When are we gonna start carrying grenades?
I'd rather be tried by 12 and carried by 6.
Newman was shot from a moving car. Extra weapons wouldn't have done him any good.
That's then. This is now. We gotta protect ourselves out there. I don't want to end up like Newman.
Who does?
I'm never going to end up like Newman, dying without a widow. I've decided to marry Trixie.
Is he serious?
He is. Whether the relationship is, we'll have to see.
Peggy.
Close the door.
Yes, Lieutenant?
I think Carrasco should be put on modified assignment for a month, and I'm talking clerical duty without his gun.
Today's without his three guns.
One of my detectives lost his life. I can't have another one taking his or somebody else's. So, please talk to him before he signs out today.
Wouldn't it be better if it came from you, Lieutenant?
No, I'd rather think so. And I think I would like you and Lacey to take Mrs. Newman, her son's personal property.
Oh, couldn't Carassa do that?
No, that'd be too hard on Carassa.
I wanted to go back to the crime scene today.
Well, you can, but, you know, first pay your respects.
We wanted to be involved in the active part of this investigation.
And you will be. First, you got to take care of this.
After I talk to Carassa.
You got a second whip here. And that carries with it some extra responsibilities. And I think you should take something with you, too.
What?
Strudel.
Strudel?
That would be good.
Look at the creeps coming here. Yeah. The traffic department is checking every summons given the last month. They're interviewing every shopkeeper in the area. They don't need us here.
Mary Beth, the DMV said it's going to take a few days to run down that license plate with the three numbers. There could be 100 cars that model.
Well, if that's all the witness saw, then I suggest
no,
we take a different tactic.
No, that's all the witness remembered. And you saw the car, too.
I saw the side of a car, Christine.
But maybe you remember more than you think you do. So let's walk through it.
I don't want to walk through it. We should be back at the precinct on the telephone or knocking on doors.
Where were you yesterday?
Oh, gee.
You were here with me, all right? Do you remember what you were talking about?
Don't you? We were talking about how come we couldn't go celebrate with Newman.
I want you to remember. I don't want you to rub it in.
I'm in no mood to play detective and witness, Christine.
Look, I could play the witness and you could play the detective, but I did not see the car. Come on, Mary Beth.
You're pushing me.
Do you remember seeing any meter maids? Traffic cops, street vendors.
I already submitted a 49, Sergeant. It's on Lieutenant Samuel's desk. You can read what I saw.
I don't want to read what you saw. I want to hear what you saw from you now.
Going over Newman's present cases could be valuable. Going over Newman's past cases could be valuable, but this is not valuable here, Christine. This is annoying. It's about as annoying as you were being yesterday.
What are you talking about?
Saying that I was a liar about having to go to Michael's school. I don't lie, Christine. And I was about to tell you that if it hadn't been for all the cars honking at that cab.
What cab?
The checker cab that was stalled, which I didn't put in my report. We find the cab driver, and maybe he saw something nobody else did.
You did good, Mary Beth. And I was terrific. Thank you. There aren't that many checker cabs left in.
We'll find out the police that still have them and check the trip cards from yesterday.
Between evening shifts and midnights, we should have the cabbie's name by tomorrow morning.
My partner's dead!
Now you find something or I'll find you.
Hey.
Al? Are you all right?
Yeah. I want him so bad I can taste it.
Yeah, but you gotta calm down, Al.
You calm down. That's easy for you to say. What if this happened to your partner? What if it was Cagney who was off? Do you think you'd keep your cool?
This is hard for all of us.
I want their best behind bars.
We all do. We all do.
Excuse me. Detective Lacey, may I speak with Detective Carassa alone, please?
Yes, Sergeant.
No, Cagney. You take me off the street, you know what you're losing? You can't do that!
I don't have a choice.
Desk duty. A lot of good I'm gonna do is on desk duty.
Al, you're tired.
Well, no need to worry. You don't have to be alert on clerical. If I misplace a stapler, no lives are endangered.
Go home and get some rest.
Thank you. My first sergeant told me we watch out for our own. If so-and-so's a cop, you might not like him. But if he needs your help, you lay down your life for him because he's a cop. Now, I'd have laid down my life for Newman because he was Jonah Newman. There were two bullets, Cagney. Why didn't the other one hit me?
Because it didn't.
Yeah, we're all out there trying to figure out what we're looking for. Well, I'll tell you what we're looking for. We're looking for a lousy shot.
Chris, come on in.
Thanks. I hope it's not too late.
No, I didn't expect to see you this week with all that's going on.
Yeah, it's been busy. How about you? How'd your deposition go tonight?
Very well. Can I get you a drink?
A double? Thank you.
Must be tough. Partner dying.
Wasn't my partner.
He was with you on that Santa Claus case.
One case.
Seemed like a nice guy when I met him.
He was on his best behavior, trust me.
I guess everybody must be pretty upset.
David, enough with the guessing, okay?
Okay.
Sorry. I really shouldn't have come. And I certainly should have called first.
If you had, I would have invited you over.
Oh, yes, but then you would have known what to expect.
You want to know the truth? I never know what to expect with you. I like that.
Keep you guessing, huh?
You don't always have to be a barrel of laughs. Can I fix you something to eat? Would you like to hear some music? We could see what's on the tube.
Could we just go to bed?
You're tired.
I just want to feel alive. Come in, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Come here. Sweetheart. What I do can be dangerous, but life is dangerous. You start thinking about all the ways you could die, you stop living anyway.
Aren't you scared?
Yeah, but it'll pass.
If we didn't have to move, you wouldn't have to work.
That's not true. We want the house. It's something we dreamed about all our lives, but I want to work, too. Oh, kiddo. I wish that I could tell you that nothing bad will ever happen to you. Or me either. But you're getting too old for me to say stuff like that to you anymore.
Sometimes that bothers me.
Sometimes it bothers me, too. Where you been? The subway was very crowded. Midnight found the cabbie. Good. He even noted a tan car with license plates similar to the ones we're looking for.
Good.
There's only one problem. The letters come before the numbers.
Can I get coffee first?
Yeah. Now, the way I see it, there are two possibilities. Either the witness or the cabbie read the license plate backwards. Dyslexia, right? Or they're not New York plates.
Every witness swore that it was a gold filled with blue figures.
Same colors as Oregon license plates, which happen to have letters preceding the numbers.
You are something else.
Thank you. Samuels approves. We can run an APB for the car with the Oregon plates while the DMV's looking up the New York plates.
It's all arranged.
What? Your marriage to your widow-to-be?
I'd like to call her my fiancée, Katie.
Does she answer?
Anyway, she is not the one that's going to make the difference. It is cryonic suspension.
What kind of suspension?
Cryonic suspension. When you die, they freeze you, then they defrost you, and they can cure whatever killed you.
The immortal is Becky.
Come on, Mary Beth. The snipers in the street await us. This freezing business. What do they put you in?
I don't know. I didn't ask. What do you guess, Marcus? Ski clothes.
This APP business, it's a long shot. You think it's worth it?
What do we have to lose? It's asking a lot of the uniform, sir, but I think that we might get us somewhere.
All right, so do it.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
First, I want the two of you to go over to Newman's apartment. I gotta know that he's clean.
Yes, sir. Lieutenant, can't you get Aspermonte or Kazak to do that?
Can you? How come every time I ask you to do something, you want me to ask someone else?
It's the things you're asking me to do. Tell his mother, visit his family, reassign Carrasa, now go through his personal effects.
I don't have to apologize to you every time I ask for your help. Sergeant!
I wasn't suggesting that you do, Lieutenant.
All right, now go to Newman's.
See if he was a crook?
No, to see if you can find something.
Yes, sir. We're on our way. Believe this. He's asking us to do what anybody could do. Maybe not him, Christine.
Feels weird, huh? I mean, it's not like going through things of people you don't know. Or people you think you know, like family.
Let's just get what we need and get out of here.
He had an amazing record collection. Chris, look at this. Must have been him when he was a boy. Okay, I know. Files, diaries. Any unusual habits?
Police, double!
Freeze!
Who are you?
Debbie Chasler. My wallet's in my bag. I don't carry a gun, only credit cards. I was his girlfriend. I sort of lived here part-time.
Put your hands down.
We apologize, Miss Chasler. I didn't mean to scare you like that. I'm Detective Lacey. This is Sergeant Cagney.
Hi.
Cagney? About you a lot. He thought you were the best detective he'd ever met. I should have known you'd be coming.
It's part of the investigation.
I guess you got to check to see if he was the terrific guy everyone said he was.
Yes, Miss Chasler. What a sweet girl she is, huh?
His appointment book didn't show any irregularities.
They were planning their honeymoon in Paris.
No signs of drug or alcohol abuse.
They wanted a lot of kids, too. Ficking Newman for being crazy about children. I didn't know that.
Maybe his checkbook or his mail will turn up something.
Right, I'm glad he had somebody to love him, Chris. Now,
will you pull yourself together?
I beg your pardon?
We're working on a case.
Yeah?
But look at how you're acting.
Somebody we both worked with has been murdered.
Yeah?
I'm not the one that's acting strange, Christine.
Lacey, your son Michael called. He sounded a little upset, so we talked for a while till he felt better.
That's nice. Thank you, Sergeant.
Well, you're very welcome. Anything I can do for you, Cagney?
You all right, Coleman? Let me guess, you found religion.
No, poetry. Here, listen to this here. I shall pass through this world but once. If there be any kindness I can show, let me do it now. for I shall not pass this way again. Pretty, huh?
Beautiful. Death could certainly change a person. Sure, look what it did for Newman.
Anybody want to help with Newman stuff?
You didn't find any dirt on him, did you?
Nothing. But we met Debbie Chaslet. She seems like a fine young woman.
Yeah. She'll have a hard time finding a guy as great as Jonah.
I'm taking his checkbook.
I'll take his telephone bills. He was always on the phone to one of his sisters.
A lot of charitable donations. Maybe I'll have to forgive him for not paying back his loans.
He's just like me, a cop's cop.
I used to say to Newman, you're a gentleman and a scholar and a good judge of Manischewitz.
He knew his ripple, too.
Christine told me once that he was very good at poker.
He's a hell of a basketball player for a short guy.
What is this, a Jonah Newman testimonial?
Some of us care that he's gone, Cagney.
You saying I don't?
I don't really know what you feel. I'm not sure you do either.
Oh, Petrie, go analyze somebody else.
We're trying to loosen up.
Come on, Cagney, what's your problem?
Everybody's walking around saying what a great guy Newman was. Nobody ever said that when you wanted me to set him up in the poker game.
We hardly knew him then.
Coleman knew him last week when he wanted McGivey instead of Newman to play shortstop on our softball team.
What's your point, Cagney?
Suddenly everybody's going around asking, did he have a wife? Gee, did he have any kids? Nobody even cared till he got killed. Nobody's even thought about Newman's personal life. Hell, nobody even knew if he had one.
Carrazza knew.
Mine, Carrazza. For the last few days, all we've heard about is what a stand-up guy Newman was. Ah, really smart and hardworking. Wow, is he honest. It's enough to make you puke. Yes, it is enough, Christine. I would like to catch the guy who killed Newman just as much as you. But I don't think that we have to anoint him first.
It's a bank thing.
Who's doing the phone bills?
Me.
Time it is?
Honey, they want us working off-duty hours, too. 12-hour shifts. You feel guilty going home at all.
I called the squadron. They said you left a long time ago.
There's fewer trains this time of night.
Damn it, Mary Beth, I worry, too.
Hey, baby. I've been taking different routes home, Harvey. Yesterday it was the F train to Delancey. And the Q11 bus from Woodhaven. Today it was the M train to Wyckoff and bus B55. I keep thinking, you know, if he was a target.
I thought you were handling it so well.
When I was pregnant, I hated being on clerical duty. But today on the street, I kept thinking, it felt so safe sitting behind manila folders.
Then do it. Put in for clerical.
That little girl makes me want to live forever. Look at her. She's so pure. So safe. When am I going to feel safe again?
Come here. Baby. Go to mommy. You know, when you first joined the force, every time we kissed goodbye, I thought it could be the last time. But holding on to those fears doesn't make you any safer. It doesn't make me any easier. So stop looking over your shoulder. Start taking the old route home.
I wish we were in the new house already.
Me too.
Have your attention, please. Have your attention, please. Everybody? 18th Precinct just called to report an arrest in the shooting of Detective Third Grade Jonah Newman. And the Ballistics has been given a 38, recovered in a car with Oregon license plates, matching the ones given by the checker cab driver to Sergeant Cagney and Detective Lacey. Both are to be congratulated.
Who is it?
Does he have a yellow sheet?
What do you have against Newman?
Let's go down to the
18. No, 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 no. There's no need for that. They asked if we want to share in the collar, and they're on their way here now.
Thank you, sir. It's him. I can feel it.
Oh, yeah.
It's him and we'll let him down, right?
Yes.
Now we're on board.
Right. I know.
Step by step.
Congratulations, step by Sergeant. Step. Hey.
Yeah. You want to come out and take the wind with us, Lieutenant?
No, no, no. I think I'll take it in here. Who's your fellow detective? New to you, Cagney, but I think you're going to find it something you can never get used to. Especially, sometimes I used to think, okay, maybe my son will be a cop. Times like this, I'm glad he's not.
Lieutenant, you are not responsible for what happened to Newman.
I know that, but a commanding officer feels responsible for everything. I wanted to go over to the Newman family, but I just wasn't ready.
Well, maybe you will be soon.
I am. Shiva's not finished yet, so I'm going to go over and see them later. The lieutenant watches all the new talent that comes in, and sometimes when you see one with such promise, such ambition and energy, and you laugh and you talk, and you know, you call Newman a hot dog, but well, he and I, we call that chutzpah. I'm sorry I leaned on you so hard, Cagney.
I'm glad you felt you could.
18th is bringing that suspect over for questioning. Someone's going to have to interrogate him, and I'd like hell to do it, but I think I owe this one to you and to Lacey.
Thank you.
Thank you.
They're frying him.
What happened?
What did he say?
Is that the scum that off Newman?
Is that our man?
Come on, tell us!
Yeah, it looks like.
What do you have against Newman?
Didn't know Newman was a cop. Even know Newman. I wanted to commit a crime. I wanted to see if I could get away with it.
Hey. Oh.
Easy, easy, easy.
Huh?
Easy,
huh?
That's
Newman's past cases better than I know my own.
I now know Newman's past girlfriends better than I know my own.
Well, that doesn't surprise me.
Hey, I thought you were going to be kind.
Yeah, but how long can that last? About as long as Becky's engagement.
Victor, what happened?
Turns out to be if I get frozen when I die, she doesn't know she's a widow or a wife waiting for a husband to defrost. The courts have got to decide before tricks he'll commit. In the meantime, we've decided to see other people.
I keep looking for something we can get out of all this.
The only one that got anything out of this was Newman. Well, he got a hell of a funeral.
Sure was. All those cops in uniform as far as the eye could see. Would have made Newman proud.
You remember? Remember the bank robber?
Oh, bank robber.
There was no bank robber.
There was an old man withdrawing his account.
Wait. The embezzler who offered Newman a partnership when he gets out of prison?
How about the hooker that promised to name her first legitimate son after Newman?
The name's going to go for very big in his career.
I wonder what Newman's doing now.
He's probably organizing a card game.
Lovely thought, Marcus.
What do you say we all go over to Flannery's and we hoist one of Newman's on?
Huh? All right. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, here's Becky. You can pay.
All right, I'll pay.
One check.
That was all for nothing, wasn't it? Some guy just getting his kicks.
Yeah.
I thought catching him would help. It didn't. I feel rotten. And a little guilty.
Because you're alive and he's dead?
No. I never really liked him. But now that he's dead, I can't say that anymore.
Why would you want to?
Because I thought he was an obnoxious little twerp.
Yes, we know. But why should I lie about it? He always irritated me. You know that. He was this smart guy always throwing the fast answers, and I hated his big phony smile, and he looked like he slept in his clothes.
And I never told him what a good cop I thought he was.
You can tell Carassa and Petrie and his Becky. They need to hear it, Christine. I'm going to Flannery's with them. You coming?
Yeah, maybe I will. I'll buy the first round, make a toast.
Yeah? That's one way of telling the person you're gonna miss them.
I said he was a good cop. But I didn't say I was gonna miss him.
Yeah. I know.